Today we will see the example of universal assembly. Let's see first of all the geometry. Our geometry is 3D, so we directly import that 3D geometry in form of IGS tiles. Let's check the geometry first of all. You can see the import symbol over here. Now it's demand generate, so make the generate. Now it extract all the components. Now you can see universal assembly part and individually you can see part over here. Right? This is our assembly. Generally application of universal joint is generally used in automobile where you require to transfer the power from one shaft to other shaft. Now next to model. In model we will mesh the whole geometry. For meshing we will explore different options. Stage wise geometry mesh, then setup, and your cell status will be changed as per your input provided. Now in mesh, first of all make it update, so by default setting it will mesh the whole geometry. Now check the meshing status. You can see it is very less denser mesh is there. So you can improve it by using the option relevance. Here it is a on positive direction. On right side it will increase the mesh density. On left side it will decrease the mesh density. You can see minus 40, and on other side you can see positive. So this is a percentage wise, like I will add 50%, so it will increase the mesh density 50% whatever the existing mass is there. Now you can see the increased mass. If you are not satisfied, you can further increase mass density to 100. Now you can see, but here you can see uniformly increase the mass density throughout whole part. So sometimes you require mass density in particular area more and other area is not required. So for that we can explore other option in sizing. First of all, reduce this zero. So one can understand the difference. Here in sizing, first is size functions. First adaptive is highlighted by default. Other than there is a four more option. Second is proximity and curvature. Curvature, proximity, uniform. First of all, we check uniform. uniform and update. It is uniformly distribute the mass and each size of the mass density. Now you can see the mass density by using uniform command. Uniform makes the mass sizing uniformly same. Now you can see mass sizing is same throughout whole assembly part. Now I will change it to proximity first. Update. Now you can see variation is area wise mass. Here there is a more denser than compared to here. So wherever the proximities are there, where there is a boundaries are there, if there is any hole or any components are attached, so it will increase the massing. Now you can see here is my higher mass density compared to here. So by using proximity you can make this difference. Then after curvature, now in curvature, wherever the curve part is there, where there is a fillets are there, it will increase the mass density over here. Next option is both proximity and curvature. So both the features applied in single command. Now you can see proximity as well as curvature. After that size function, there is a relevance center is there. First of all, make it is adaptive so you can understand the difference between this option. Now coarse is highlighted. Now there is a three option total: coarse, medium and fine. Let's make it medium and update. It is a medium wise denser, then fine. You can see it is finer throughout hole. So basically for increase the or control the massing in each part, there is a two method: local control and global control. Whatever we have seen, that is a global control. It's affect the whole part of the geometry, each and every part in assembly. So there is also few commands are there where you can control locally. Next we analyze this component. So in static structure we provide the boundary conditions. First, support. We know that on one side we will make this face fixed like side. On other side, we provide the moment. Moment provide the value and direction. Now you can see direction is anti-clockwise. If you want to change it in direction, now it is a clockwise. Now boundary condition is over. Next stage is a solution. Solve. It will solve our problem based on your processor capacity and also your mass density. It will take time based on these two factors. If you have higher configuration, it will take less time. Now solution has done. Next stage is to check the solution. First total deformation and stresses. Click on deformation. Now you can see the deformation value in MM. You can change the unit in meter. There is a very small, make it centimeter as per your requirement. Now provide the animation. Now you can simulate the result. It is verified as an actual behavior. When you actually apply the moment and fix it other side, it will deflect like this. Let's check the stress value. Now you can see. Very few stresses are there, 0.31 megapascal. Based on the moment you applied, let's change the moment value to 1000. Now solve it. Here, after solution, there is a higher in form of deformation as well as stresses. Now solution has been done. Now you can see deformation is increased, stress is also increased. Here the result you can see is based on the effect transfer from here. We apply the moment, so the moment effect has been transferred from one component to other. So that's why you can see the stresses value in other part where we have placed the fixed. So it is due to the connection that automatically defined by the software. You can see different types of connection in each component. you can manually add the connection. Insert manual contact region. Click on that. It will ask contact and target surface. You can select contact and target. Theoretically, contact surfaces are those surfaces which used to apply the force, and target surface are those which bear the force. In contact, let's click on this surface, apply, and the target surface, this surface, and apply. Now you can see one contact has been defined, but we know that already contact, this contact is defined, so we will delete this contact. I will show you only so you can use it. Due to this contact, the effect is transferring from one part to another. Now again, solid, because we have changed in contact regions, that's why it's demand solution again. There is a different types of contacts are there. Whatever it will take by default is a bonded contact. In bonded, there is a fixed, like glue contacts are there. Two parts are glued with each other. There is other contacts are there, like frictional contact, frictionless contact. Here you can see that different contacts. Bonded, no separation, frictionless, rough, frictional, force frictional. As per the real-time condition, you can select this contact. I will make by default bonded. Now you can see the results. Let's explore this edges option. Already highlight is a show element. Now go for no wireframe. Here you can see the no wireframe option. Then show undeformed wireframe. It will highlight the edges. You can differentiate the deformation. Same way, there is a use undeformed model. Is one highlighted model will be there. Here you can differentiate. Apart from that, show element, you know that. Apart from there is a contours are there. Here already contour band is highlighted. Let's check smooth contour. Now you can see smoothly they are merging with each other. So it is a good to visualize. If you want to check the inside status, like this is stress, I'm going to check the inside stress as well. So for that, I can take this section, take this section like this. Now you can see this highlighted part. This is the original geometry, this is a deformed geometry. If you want to remove it, make it nowhere, it will remove. Inside the cross section, you can see here cross section has been created. Use this edit plane. Now you can play with the cross section where you want to place your cross section and check the inside status. Let's change the mesh density and check the what is the makes difference in the result. Proximity and curvature and update. So the mesh density will increase. Then after we will solve this example, we will come to know the results, difference in two results. Now you can see the fineness. It is a combination of proximity and curvature and fine. Now I will solve this. It will take more time compared to previous one because more number of nodes have created. So the calculating the each and every node, because there is an equation has been created and solved, so it will take more time. You can see the different status, preparing the mathematical model, then after solution, writing result file, likewise status displayed. Now you can see the solving the mathematical model. You can see it is still solving. Now solving the mathematical model. Then after writing result file. You can stop the solution in between or interrupt the solution. You can see writing result file. Evaluating and solved. Deformation near about same, stresses, you can see stress has been reduced 1.9, previous one 3 point something. Now 6, you can see from changes of 1 megapascal. So likewise iteratively you supposed to solve it, and ultimately you supposed to come on the stage where the result will become constant. There is no effect after changing. So that is your acceptable level of results. So based on requirement, you can create report preview. You can generate your report preview by just clicking over here. Now you can see each and every detail has been displayed over here in the preview report. You can add more elements like pictures, boundary condition pictures and graphs and charts and more. You can export it by just send to Word and PowerPoint as per your requirement. Let's back to geometry. So these are analysis
of static structure of universal joint.